Marcus in Orange County, California. Welcome to the Line of Fire.
Hi, how you doing?
Very well, thank you, sir.
Hi. So I don't know, from my perspective, from a, you know, a voting standpoint, you know, I go back to the Bible. It talks, Jesus said his kingdom isn't of this world, and that we who are born again don't entangle ourselves with things of the world. So from my perspective, Jesus, when he was on the cross, said, I pray not for the world. So I don't think our kingdom is even of this world. So this is the thing that the Gentiles vote about, right?
No, not at all. Didn't he say, render to Caesar the things that belong to Caesar? Didn't Paul say,
correct,
pay taxes to whom it's due? So that's our money.
Right.
Don't they you work? Do you work? Do you work a job?
Right. That's the work of my flesh. So the works of your flesh are the works of your flesh. And children of the flesh are not children of God. So that makes
sense. Wait, so hang on. When you work a job, you're in the flesh?
Of course. I don't come in there and say, hey, my spirit's working a job right now. I have to show up in the flesh.
Oh, no, but it said, but the Bible says the flesh cannot possibly please God. Whatever I do
exactly
is unto the Lord. When I eat a meal, I do it as unto the Lord. When I'm having fun with family, I do it as unto the Lord. When I was doing secular work as a salesman, I did that as unto the Lord. When I vote, I do it as unto the Lord.
Well, Dr. Brown, when the Bible says the children of the flesh are not children of God, and they that are in the flesh cannot please God, neither does God doesn't go on the temple made with hands, needs to be worshipped with man's hands. I think the point is that we can't please God in our flesh. That is the point. Children of the flesh aren't children of God.
Right. So we're not in the flesh. We're in the spirit. We die to the flesh when we come to Jesus. You're making a false dichotomy here. And based on this false dichotomy, you shouldn't even go feed the poor or help the needy because that's all in the flesh. His kingdom not being of this world means it doesn't operate based on worldly principles. But his kingdom is working in this world every single day. The kingdom of God is advancing and touching lives every single day. And when babies are being aborted, God cares about that. When children are being sex trafficked, God cares about that. When people are starving and nations with a surplus don't help, God cares about that.
Dr. Brown, can I say this just one last thing?
Yeah, sure.
When Jesus talks about feeding the poor, he's talking about the bread of life. He's talking about eating the bread that I give, you'll never.
No, sir. No, sir.
The water y'all give, you'll never.
No, sir.
Can I finish my statement, please?
Well, no, Marcus, you're butchering the Bible, sir. You're making a mockery of the gospel. Yeah, I'm just being totally candid with you, Marcus. You're making a mockery of the Bible. You're making a mockery of the faith of Jesus, making a mockery of his words. When he says in Matthew 25:31-46, that when you've done it to the least of these, you've done it to me, he's talking about literally visiting his people who are in prison for the gospel, in jail. He's talking about literally clothing the naked. He's talking about literally feeding the hungry. Based on what you're saying, you shouldn't eat or drink because you're just a spirit man. It is complete 100% misrepresentation of scripture, sir. It's shockingly so. And then you're putting verses together that are completely unrelated in a very dangerous way. And to me, it is making a complete separation. My spirit, soul, and body, these are all given over to God. Paul says in 1 Thessalonians 5:23, he prays that God would sanctify us wholly, spirit, soul, and body. Right? We present our bodies to God as a living sacrifice. Our whole life belongs to him. Whatever we do, whether we eat or drink, we do it to the glory of God. So we don't live like the world lives. We're in this world. We're not of it. But we should be the best citizens. We should be the most faithful, hard workers. We should glorify God in everything that we do. We don't separate flesh and spirit in terms of, well, that's just my flesh. I mean, you might as well tell your wife that when you're committing adultery, well, that's just my body, but my spirit was being loyal to you. I mean, please, sir, please step back and consider what you're saying, because this is a dangerous, dangerous way of thinking. Dangerous way of thinking. I've watched it play out. I've actually had people tell me, hey, my body sins, I don't sin, my spirit can't sin. So if my body sins, that's not the issue because I can't sin, I'm a spirit man. It's a dangerous way of thinking, Marcus. Please reconsider. Thank you.